Good morning, everyone. Please sing hymn 65 from the Red Book. Welcome to our online chapel. Today I'll be the first and only announcement, and then we will move on to a presentation. So today is a very, very special day. It's Rachel Fu's 16th birthday. Rachel, I wish you all the best. I wish you a very, very happy birthday, and I hope you're spending this day safe and healthy and with your beloved ones. So as the school remains closed till May 3rd, I'd like to welcome you in Poland. We are currently in my little room in my apartment in Łódź. And maybe I'll begin by showing you on a map where we at. So Poland is a country in Europe. It is a part of Central Europe as well as Eastern Europe. Our neighbors are, this tiny part right here is Russia, Lithuania, Belarus, Ukraine, Slovakia, Czech Republic, and Germany. Poland is a pretty simple country. As we can see, we've got one sea over here, and all of the mountains are right here. I live in Łódź, which is literally the city right in the middle of Poland. It's this city with very weird letters, and it's about an hour and a half away from Warsaw. That is a capital city of my country. And this is my neighborhood. That's what I can see from my window. I live in a very tiny three floor apartment building, and I share my apartment with my mother, who unfortunately has to go to work every single day. So most of the time during the quarantine, I'm completely alone at home, and what I really like to do is do some cleaning around the house, around my closets. As I'm not very often here, I feel like I gathered a lot of unnecessary stuff, and I'm really using this free time to organize my room and my apartment. Also, I'm enjoying my national food. I cook a lot, I eat a lot, and I think that really makes me happier because I feel a very strong cultural connection with my home food. On the weekends, I really get to spend time with my mother. Most of the time, we just talk a lot about my university, as I'll be going to college very, very soon, and it's a whole new chapter of my life that I'm very excited for. We also watch Netflix together and do a lot of online shopping. Moreover, depending on the week, we try to spend either Saturday or Sunday with my grandmother, just cooking together, eating together. But I feel like I'm talking a lot about food, so I'm just gonna show you what Polish national dishes look like. Let me begin with the most known Polish food. That's pierogi. Not pierogis, it's pierogi. And they are dumplings, usually stuffed with meat or cheese and onion. And the thing that you can see on the top, it's just fried onion. This one right here is called kotlet schabowy. It's pork chop that has been fried in breadcrumbs. And we usually serve it with mashed potatoes over there and sauerkraut, which is cooked cabbage. It's kind of sour. Let me tell you, we are crazy about soups in this country. We have tens of different kinds of soups here that are considered to be national. And I think one of the most interesting ones is this one right here that is called zupa ogórkowa. Normally you would translate it as a cucumber soup, but in fact it's made of pickles. So it's a Polish pickle soup, and we serve it with carrot and potatoes, and we usually cook it on meat. I would like to tell you also about our Eastern traditions. So basically, normally if we were not in quarantine, obviously, we would go to church. on Saturday with a basket that includes a piece of bread, sausage, salt, pepper, a few eggs that we decorate the night before, and a small statue of a sheep, and that's made of sugar. We always go there. It's a very short mass where the priest uses the holy water and blesses all of us. Then on Sunday, we eat that food and other food with our families and our homes. And then Monday is a fun day. So Monday is called in Polish Śmigus Dingus, which is basically a one day long water war around the country. Here you can see people from the mountains wearing traditional Polish clothing and celebrating Śmigus Dingus. So basically around the cities, countrysides, everywhere in the country, kids and also adults are running around with water guns and baskets full of water, and it's a very happy day, and it really makes me sad that this year we will not be able to organize the neighborhood water war as we usually did. Easter this year won't be anything close to the one year ago or 2 years ago, that's for sure. However, what really keeps me positive throughout quarantine is giving back to my community. And because, as I told you, I clean a lot of stuff in my home, I found a lot of unnecessary things like clothing, my winter clothing from when I was an 8-year-old girl. So a week ago, I donated 8 bags full of coats, jackets, and all of that stuff to a local orphanage. And the way I did it was very safe, as I was driven there by my father and we did not have a physical contact with people from the orphanage. I called the place a few hours before asking if it's possible for me to leave things outside of their building. They said yes, for sure. So basically we drove there, we left the bags outside of the building, and when we got back to the car, I called the orphanage and asked for someone to go out and take the bags inside so they don't get stolen. And I think it's very simple, and I'm pretty sure that all of you can practice giving back to your community in this very strange time. But at the same time, you can keep yourself safe, and you can still be positive about these days and really do something that keeps you busy and not bored sitting on your couch just watching Netflix. Whether it's donating your old clothing, food to a local food bank, or just recycling or doing grocery shopping for your neighbors or grandparents or parents, there are so many ways to give back to your community. And I would love to encourage you to spend your time in a very positive way. I know it's difficult, but we're all in this together, as one of the popular High School Musical songs says. All we can do right now is support each other and stay home as much as we can. And if we go out, please, please don't put yourself at risk and don't put others at risk. And yes, happy Easter and take care. I'll see you probably next week. Have a great day, everyone, and stay safe.